Hello dears, how are you? First of all, I wish you good health and beautiful family life. And start this session. In this video, we are going to see that how to fix error 403, disallowed user agent inside the web view of Android. So total practical is based on Android Studio 4.0. So if sometimes happen that on the left side, error has came, that error 403 disallowed user agent, and right side we clear the error and fix the error and get the output. So let's see how we can do this one. So as per the Android guideline, upgrade your studio to latest version Android Studio 4.0. So understanding, in this practical we are going to use view binding to replaces the find view by IDs. So let's start how to fix error 403 disallowed user agent inside the web view of Android. So go to empty activity inside the Android Studio, then go to build.gradle file, and inside the build.gradle file, it is not dependency, so we need to add this line view binding enable equals to true inside the Android block. Make sure your internet connection is on. It is OTS, means one time step. So after that, we do not need to write any find view by IDs. So design your main screen with one web view inside the constraint layout. And after that, load URL inside web view. And we are trying to resolve the error. So I'm going to file new, then new project with the empty activity, click on next and write that demo underscore 403e. It is Java based, so click on finish, all the steps will be ready. So go to build.gradle file for the view binding capabilities. So just I add view binding, then enable equals to true. There is no semicolon is needed. Click on sync now, make sure your internet connection is on. So after that, there is no need for find view by IDs for the components. So let's see, now the view binding is added to our project. So go to design or screen and just we change to web view. Okay, and give the ID for that, @ plus ID, then my web view. Okay. So width will be match parent, height will be match parent. There is no need for text. So this screen is ready. If we see this one, likewise, you can watch this one. So inside the split one, there is one only web view with the ID of my web view. Width is match parent and height is match parent. So go to main activity.java file. And first we add view binding capabilities or code for the view binding. Just I add activity underscore main, activity underscore main binding. It is automatically generated file. We don't need to make it, and make the instance with the binding. Initialize that binding, activity main binding dot inflate, and get layout inflator over here. We need to replace r dot layout dot activity underscore main with the binding dot get root. So binding dot get root. Okay, so the up to now this code is ready. Yes, you know that we need one permission that to access internet, uses permission of internet. So we have given to android manifest.xml. This is for the accessing internet. Just I close this android manifest one and write the code over here. Likewise, I am going to write binding dot my web view dot set web view client, or set web view client, it is set web view client, and over here just I write new, then web view client. Okay, after that just I write binding dot my web view dot load URL in whatever the URL, if you have, then you can write it over here. Likewise, if I try to write https://developer.android.com/studio, so there is one line I have added to this one, and just I press shift F10. So let's see what happens with this one. So it is very easy how to load URL inside WebView. Then let's see inside the emulator. Okay, so make sure your internet connection is on, and you can see that particular https developer.android.com, and whatever the currently authorization error is in the front, so of AVD. So we try to resolve this error. So just I back button to press, because we need to write one more step to resolve this one. So I just write binding dot my webview dot get settings dot set user agent string. Over here just I write Chrome, okay, and whatever the current version with the mobile side, just I am going to write. Just one line we need to add over here. So if it's an Android phone, then basically Chrome should be there. So that's why just I write this line only for the Chrome purpose or the Chrome browser. So let's see to the emulator and press shift F10, and right now currently URL will be loaded. Let's see this one. Yes, so URL is loaded perfectly, so there is no error. It's a simple and easy way to write or to came with the error 403 or fix the error 403. It is certain more way also. Likewise, if we want to make for the other site or other browser, then you can make the string likewise this one also. So if you don't want to write or you are not satisfied with one, then it's a use for you. So this one, just I comment this one, and just I set one string with Mozilla Firefox, Chrome and Safari, and just set this one. So all the things are same at the level of this one. So once the URL is loaded, then it is supportive file. Either you work with the Mozilla or work with the Apple WebKit or Chrome or Safari. Let's see what happens with this one. So URL, press shift F10, and let's see currently what happens. So again, you can see this way is also working. So satisfied by your exit requirement. Just conclusion is that error should be solved. So it's a very easy way to resolve or fix the error of error 403 disallowed user agent. So we have seen that how the error has been in the front of WebView inside the Android and how to fix error 403. So this video is completed. So thanks for watching this video, and keep coding, keep learning, be happy, like it, subscribe with your friends. Thank you very much.